Blackstone presents the McCaw Podcast Universe, the Marvel Cinematic Universe, Phase 2, a collection of episodes from the McCaw Podcast Universe series, hosted by Jordan Marie McCaw and Micah McCaw.
Welcome to the McCaw Podcast Universe.
This is the podcast where we analyze franchises, sequels, universes.
Not sequels. We go three. It's got to be three or more.
Well, yeah, but that would include sequels. Okay, sequels are anything after one.
I thought you meant just two.
No. Like I just mean we're analyzing series and in movies, and we're trying to see how they work, how they integrate with one another, if they're good, if they're bad. And we are returning now back to our first series that we've been tackling. So we did Phase 1, then we took a break and did Mad Max.
Phase 1 of what?
Of Marvel, the cinematic universe, that is. And now we're back, and we're kicking it off with the first of Phase 2, which is Iron Man 3.
And a quick shout out to Anthony, our producer, for making such a great theme song.
Yes.
Because we recorded most of these episodes. Besides this, this is like the first episode we're recording
after the podcast has come out.
Yes. So we have not heard the theme song until now, and we love it.
Yeah, so big thanks to Anthony. It's very cool.
Yes.
It's way different than I thought he was going to do.
Me
but
too.
I love it. I love it. So, yeah. So the table is... We got to set the table a little bit, because it's been a while. So this is Marvel's seventh movie in this series. And the last one was Avengers. And I don't think that this has happened yet, but I distinctly remember there being kind of a couple of years, this moment where people were like, okay, I think this is kind of the end of the superhero era.
Oh, okay.
And
I just don't remember the time.
Yeah, not that people were saying it's over, but they were... I heard a lot the whole thing of, well, someday the superhero genre is going to fall because it's the same as Westerns. They were huge in the 50s and 60s, and then they fell.
Yeah.
And so that was kind of being talked about a little bit.
Okay.
And I think it really hits home in the next couple of years.
Yeah.
And then Guardians kind of flips it all on its head, which we'll get to when we get there. But this movie, I think, is kind of one of a contributing factor to the superhero fatigue. This is my own opinion.
I've never heard of it compared to Westerns. That's kind of mind-blowing.
Yeah. But the thing is that superhero movies aren't, like, restricted to a time period or, like, a look.
Yeah, I guess that's true.
Know? So, because I've heard that a lot.
You don't think they're constricted to a look?
No, I mean, I think they tend to be a certain look, but they don't have to. I mean, look at Spider-Verse.
Okay.
Even look at movies that are outside of the MCU. They look pretty different. Or, as we saw last night, even though it wasn't good, I mean, Brightburn was much different. And that's a spin on a superhero.
Yeah.
I don't know. It just kind of seems like maybe that wasn't true. Because also, years before Iron Man, there was the X-Men, which were pretty popular, and Spider-Man, which was huge.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't know that that's a great analogy.
I also feel like it's too early to make that call, because Westerns were around for so long before they kind of died off. And we're only on the seventh movie of this specific franchise. And they're already saying that. That's a little like jumping the gun.
I think Ultron is where that was like, okay, this is definitely going to like simmer down.
Hmm.
And it is funny watching it because, you know, 2 months ago, Endgame came out, and it's... Maybe by the time this episode comes out, it might be the highest grossing movie ever made.
Yeah.
So,
hopefully,
it's fingers crossed. Yeah. It's very interesting. Do you want me to just hop in?
So you want to go first?
Yes. But you jump in when I say certain names, because I got like Shane Black, but I don't have any of his credits or anything.
Oh, I got Mr. Black.
Okay, because we got Iron Man 3.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.